हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट टुडे आई विल डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 2.2 ऑफ क्लास 9th. स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. इन द फोर्थ पार्ट वी हैव गिवन अ पॉलीनोमियल px इज इक्वल टू x प्लस 1 इंटू x माइनस 2. वी हैव टू चेक माइनस 1 एंड प्लस 2 आर द जीरो ऑफ दिस पॉलीनोमियल और नॉट. सो टू चेक माइनस 1 इज अ जीरो ऑफ दिस पॉलीनोमियल, वी विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस पॉलीनोमियल एट x इज इक्वल टू माइनस 1. सो at x is equal to minus 1, the value of polynomial p is p minus 1 is equal to minus 1 plus 1. The value of x is minus 1 and minus 2. So it will be 0 and it will be minus 3. 0 into minus 3 is equal to 0. So the value of polynomial at minus 1 is 0. So this minus 1 is a 0 of this polynomial. Well, since value of polynomial at x is equal to minus 1 is 0, therefore minus 1 is a 0 of given polynomial px. Now we will check at x is equal to 2. At x is equal to 2, the value of polynomial is p2 is equal to 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 1. 2 plus 1 is 3 and 2 minus 2 is 0. So 3 into 0 is 0. So the value of polynomial at x is equal to 2 is 0. So we can say that 2 is a 0 of the given polynomial px. Since value of the polynomial at x is equal to 2 is 0, therefore 2 is a 0 of the given polynomial px. Now solution number 5th part of question number 3. Here given polynomial is x square. We will check 0 is a 0 is a 0 of this polynomial or not. So we will find the value of the given polynomial at x is equal to 0. This is p0. p0 is equal to 0 square is equal to 0. Here we see that the value of polynomial at x is equal to 0 is 0. So we can say that 0 is a this 0 is a 0 of this given polynomial. This is 6th part of question number 3. Here given polynomial is px is equal to lx plus m. Here we will see that the value of x is equal to minus m upon l is a 0 of the given polynomial. So we will put the value of x minus m upon l. So we see that the value of polynomial at x is equal to minus m upon l is p minus m upon l is equal to l into, here we put the value of x minus m upon l, l will be cancelled out by l, plus m minus m plus m is equal to 0. Here we see that the value of polynomial is 0 at x is equal to minus m upon l. So minus m upon l is a 0 of this given polynomial. Since value of the given polynomial px at x is equal to minus m upon n is 0, therefore minus m upon l is a 0 of px. This is solution number 7, 7th part of question number 3. Here given polynomial is px is equal to 3x square minus 1. Here we will check minus 1 upon root 3, whether it is a 0 of this given polynomial or not. So we will find the value of this polynomial at x is equal to minus 1 upon root 3. So the value of polynomial at minus 1 upon root 3, p minus 1 upon root 3 is equal to 3 into, here we put the value of x, minus 1 upon root 3 square minus 1 is equal to 3. And we know that the minus 1 square is plus 1 and root 3 square is 3. Minus 1, 3 cancel out by 3. So minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So the value of given polynomial is 0 at x is equal to minus 1 upon root 3. So we can say that the value of a given polynomial px at x is equal to minus 1 upon root 3 is 0. Therefore, minus 1 upon root 3 is a 0 of given polynomial px. Again, we will check at 2 upon root 3. At 2 upon root 3, the value of given polynomial is p 2 upon root 3 is equal to 2 into, here we put the value of x, 2 upon root 3. So it will be 2 upon root 3 square minus 1. 3 into 2 square is 4 and root 3 square is 3 minus 1. 3 cancel out by 3. 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Here the value of given polynomial is not 0 at 2 upon root 3. Therefore, 2 upon root 3 is not a 0 of the given polynomial. Since value of the given polynomial px at x is equal to 2 upon root 3 is not 0, therefore 2 upon root 3 is not 0 of given polynomial px. Student, this is part 8 of question number 3. Here given polynomial is px is equal to 2x plus 1. Here we will check the value of given polynomial at 1 upon 2. Since p 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 into, here we put the value of x is 1 upon 2 plus 1. 2 cancel out by 2. So it will be 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. The value of given polynomial is 2 at 1 upon 2. So 1 upon 2 is not a 0 of the given polynomial. Since value of given polynomial is, to a polynomial px at x is equal to 1 upon 2 is not 0, therefore 1 upon 2 is not 0 of given polynomial. Now we will solve question number 4. Here in question number 4, find zeros of the polynomial in each of the following cases. In we have to find the zero of the given polynomials. So in question number first, the given polynomial is px is equal to x plus 5. We know that the zero of the polynomial is the value of variable at which the given polynomial becomes zero. So we can see that here, if we want to become this polynomial zero, we have to put here the value of x minus 5. If we put minus 5 in the place of x, then it will be minus 5 plus 5, 0. So the zero of this polynomial is minus 5. And in second part, this polynomial x minus 5 becomes 0 if we put the value of x here plus 5. So plus 5 minus 5 becomes 0. So value of polynomial becomes 0 if we put here the value of x plus 5. So plus 5 is the 0 of this given polynomial. In third part, what value we can put here in the place of x so that it becomes 0. So here we put, if we put minus 5 upon 2, 2 cancel out by 2 and minus 5 plus 5 becomes 0. So the value of this polynomial becomes 0 if we put the value of x minus 5 upon 2. So minus 5 upon 2 is the 0 of this given polynomial. We will solve this question in detail also. I will discuss now orally, but in detail we will solve these questions. In fourth part, px given polynomial px is equal to 3x minus 2. So what value we can put here in place of x so that it becomes 0? So if we put here the value of x 2 upon 3, then 3 cancel out by 3 and it will be 2 minus 2, 0. So we can say that the 2 upon 3 is a 0 of this given polynomial. Now students, you can see that how can we put here at the place of x so that it will become 0. So clearly we can see that here we will put 0, and if we put 0 in the place of x, it will be 0. So we can say that 0 is the polynomial of this polynomial. 0 is the 0 of this polynomial. Okay, now in sixth part, px is equal to ax. What is the value of x here? Here the value of x will be 0. If we put the value of x here 0, it will be 0. So we can say that 0 is the polynomial. 0 is the 0 of this polynomial. In this seventh part, this polynomial cx plus d, what is the value of x here so that it will become 0? So if we put the value of x minus d upon c, it will become 0. So we can say that minus d upon c is the 0 of this given polynomial. So we have discussed here orally. Now we will explain, we will solve this question one by one. So solution number 4, fourth, first part. Given polynomial is px is equal to x plus 5. So how can we find the 0 of this polynomial? For finding the 0 of the polynomial px, we will put px is equal to 0. That is, what is px? Px is x plus 5. So we will put x plus 5 is equal to 0. It implies that when we transpose plus 5 in right hand side, it will become minus 5. So x is equal to minus 5. This is the value of x. Hence minus 5 is a 0 of given polynomial px. So minus 5 is a 0 because if we put here minus 5, it will become 0. Second part of question number 4. Here given polynomial is px is equal to x minus 5. For finding 0 of px, we will put px is equal to 0. That is, what is px? Px is x minus 5. So x minus 5 is equal to 0. And we transpose minus 5 from left hand side to right hand side, it will become plus 5. Therefore x is equal to plus 5. Therefore 5 is the 0 of given polynomial px. Now question number third part of question number 4. Here given polynomial is px is equal to 2x plus 5. For finding 0 of px, we will put px is equal to 0. What is px? Px is 2x plus 5. So we will put the value of px, 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. It implies that 2x is equal to minus 5. We transpose plus 5 to right hand side. So 2x is equal to minus 5, and 2, x is equal to minus 5 upon 2. 2 will come in the denominator of minus 5. Therefore, minus 5 upon 2 is a 0 of the given polynomial px. This is third part of question number 4. Here given polynomial is px is equal to 2x plus 5. For finding 0 of px, we put px is equal to 0. That is 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. We transpose plus 5 to right hand side. It implies that 2x is equal to minus 5. It implies that x is equal to minus 5 upon 2. Therefore, minus 5 upon 2 is a 0 of given polynomial px. Fourth part of question number 4. Given polynomial is px is equal to 3x minus 2. For finding 0 of px or for finding the 0 of given polynomial, we put px is equal to 0. It implies that what is value of px? Px 3x minus 2. So we can replace px by 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. And 3x is equal to plus 2 minus this minus 2 when come in right hand side become plus 2. And it implies that x is equal to 3 when 3 is transposed to right hand side, it will come in the denominator of 2. So it will be x is equal to 2 upon 3. Therefore 2 upon 3 is a 0 of given polynomial px. Fifth part of question number 4. Here given polynomial is px is equal to 3x. For finding 0 of px, we have px is equal to 0. It implies that 3x is equal to 0. Because the value of px is 3x, so we will put in the place of px 3x is equal to 0. It implies that x is equal to 0 upon 3. 0 upon 3 is equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is the 0 of given polynomial px. For sixth part of question number 4, given polynomial is px is equal to ax, where a is not equal to 0. For finding 0 of px, we have px is equal to 0. It implies that the value of px is ax, ax is equal to 0. It implies that we see that here the product of a and x is equal to 0, it means either a or b is 0. So, but a is not equal to 0, it is given here. So, it implies that x is equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is the polynomial of given polynomial px. Solution number 7th part of question number 4. Given polynomial is px is equal to cx plus d, where c is not equal to 0. For finding 0 of given polynomial px, we have px is equal to 0. What is value of px? Cx plus d. So we put here cx plus d is equal to 0. It implies that cx is equal to plus d becomes minus d in the right hand side. So cx is equal to minus d and x is equal to minus d upon c. Therefore, minus d upon c is a 0 of given polynomial px. ओके स्टूडेंट, फिर आज के लिए इतना ही रहने देते हैं. नेक्स्ट वीडियो में हम रिमाइंडर थ्योरम डिस्कस करेंगे. थैंक यू.